back and I'm talking a little bit more about making your own stencils to emboss with. Once again, I want to repeat that we're using Wonder Goo. Even though we're not showing that right now, in our original video we did show the specifics of how to do it. We're just going on now and showing you additional things that you can do with this technique. I'm back using Spellbinders Wizard, and I'm using Spellbinders dies because they do emboss. And these actually, oh, look how dirty that is. I need to clean my dies, don't I? You can use this side like a brass stencil. I love to airbrush through them. I think they're just absolutely gorgeous. But I wanted to show you what these dies look like if they're done. This is die cut, embossed, and then inked. So I'm going to put the three little dies on the blue paper so that you can see how they look.
And that's if you do all the steps of the wizard.
That's if you die cut, you emboss, and then you ink them. And you can see where the openings were, the apertures were in the dies. You can see how that comes through as an embossed, a raised area on here. Okay, so I don't know if you can see this. This one here I did the pencil technique. So I sketched my design on there, and then I've gone over that with a couple layers of glossy accent. And then I just took a plain piece of paper and die cut it again, and then I laid it over this and embossed it like we showed in the prior video. So this time, when I ink them up, you can see the difference. There's the original one here, and this is my design over here. So you could take any die cut, even though it embosses and has its own design, and change that out to any design that you want. So again, here's the original heart, and then here's the die that I did by using the little stencil that I made here. I put some dots over here. I don't think you can see them. But you can see how you can take the original die cut that embosses and change that out to a die cut that has your design to emboss on it. So I think it makes the dies even more versatile than what they already are. The final one here then is just a simple little heart. I've always loved this one here. And then I took mine, and I don't know if you could see that, but when I ink that up, then you can tell what that looks like. Now what I want to show here is, again, this is the embossed area, and when you swipe your pad, your ink pad across that, like Tori said, you can use any ink pad on the market out there, swipe it across it, those raised areas, the ink will hit that, and that will pop with the ink, and the rest of your card will stay the original color. But look what I've done here. If you flip it over, I have debossed ridges, and so when you ink that, the flat area shows up, and the debossed ridges stay completely white. So I'm going to show that again. This is the embossed side inked, and that's the debossed side ink. Now, why would you want to do anything with the back side of this? Well, it's white cardstock. There really isn't a back or a front to it. But what I did is I come in and I took Stickles Glitter Glue from Ranger, and I just went into those debossed ridges. Now, my item is completely flat on the top. Nothing sticks out because that glitter glue went down into the debossed areas. So again, just another technique, something else that you can do with the dies that you have. And once again, I'm going to go back. There's the original die cut. There it is with my design that I made with my stencil using glossy accents and Wonder Goo. And then here it is debossed, filled with glitter. You can fill this with seed beads, with rhinestones, with just basically anything.
Embossing powders.
Anything that's going to go down into that debossed ridge. So again, that's our technique from Lucy Magoo for making your own stencil to emboss with.